points and opening jobs. Sometimes they advertise the job will be open in July, even when it hasn't come. Maybe this is January and they say in July we'll be opening this. So you know about the current job and the future jobs. And then you get more information about career sectors, more information about the industry, about government. You want to work for government, the agencies of government, or you want to be an entrepreneur. So you find all of this in a network. And then you find colleagues who may need your help. So you don't always go to networking meetings or being in a network just to tap. You can also go there to find people that you give to. Because in this life, if you learn a lot and you don't give it out, you have wasted all that was invested in you. So you may also go in pursuit of who needs your help. So this all we do in a network. And if you look at that network, that web, the spider's web, you can see it has horizontal and it has vertical. So such is network. We have levels of experience in the network, people with diverse experiences, the middle, the early, the advanced. You have the places of employment. In a network, you have those working in government, working in different places, depending on the network. And then also you have types of employment, small, big, you have them. And then those who have intern jobs, permanent jobs, tenured, different kinds of jobs. And then you have cultural diversity. You have those who come from different cultures. So you also learn a lot about cultures and about managing people in a network. So where do you start from? Dismantles the woman. So you can start getting into a network by engaging presenters at conferences and workshops like this. You engage your neighbors, people sitting by you. You have a lot of people who are potentials, who are potential champions, who are potential mentors, who are potential coaches by you. But because you have closed your mouth from beginning to the end, you don't have opportunity to make a shirt from my life, a shirt, you can go. You work in this place and all that. So you'll be able to talk with people and you can activate a network. On campus, like in University of Porako, most of us are from University of Porako, but few of us are from industry, University of Porako Teaching Hospital, and the media. So, but on campus here, if I bring you home, make contacts with professors. You have a lot of them, and you keep saying they're far away. Have you gone, anyone sent you out? Make contact with professors, renowned scholars, and then go to the Center for Research Management office. They have a lot of calls, grants, all forms of things, fellowships, training. Go there, interact with them. Is there anything available? Go out to build a network. And then alumni association. After graduating from the University of Porako, do you ever go to alumni office to ask what is happening there? Alumni has a lot of opportunities for its members. So join alumni association, go for the meetings. Create contacts across the organization. Some persons are in management, sciences. They don't know anybody in faculty of engineering. They said, if it was in my faculty, I would have known. Says who? Go across organizations and make contact. Attend events in other organizations, UST, BIASA. One of my guests came from BIASA. Billy Remani came from BIASA. So go across institutions and hear what is happening there. We don't just cage ourselves to a place and we think we're making effective network. We cannot. Volunteer. Had a committee planning this event. I didn't pay them. Volunteer work. At the end of the day, they learn how to manage scientific activity like this one, manage the meeting and all that. So volunteer. Give yourself to do something, not being paid, and you learn a lot. Because people you function in this capacity for appreciate it so much, so they open up so you can learn more. Do more of volunteering. For the university, volunteer. Don't always think of being paid for committees, for different things. The university wants you to do, or the hospital, or wherever you work. Establish contacts and social gatherings. It may be the church, it may be sporting complex, wherever you go, social gatherings. Establish contacts and know people. Go for inaugural lectures. A lot of people don't go for inaugural lectures in this university. And the members of this community, either as grad students or as staff members. Only when our friends are presenting that they go, or people from our faculty, or even from our departments. No, you should go for all inaugural lectures. Knowledge is limitless. There is no limit to what we can learn from any presenter. Seminar series in faculties, in departments, we go there, we build networks. So to remain connected, There must be trust because they are interconnected. Sincerity, reliability, commitment, integrity, all revolve around trust. Once you put a hole in trust, you lose the network, you lose the contact you have created. So always be very, very conscious of making sure that you can be trusted in the relationship. So we have activity two. I want to have some pairs here. Can I have 6 graduate students come here? 6 graduate students, please, can I have you here? 6 graduate students. Yeah, run down here, please. I want you to conduct an interview. Just come here. Yes, I want you to talk to yourself for a few minutes. Conduct a networking conversation with your partner. Please, let's see six of you here. Yes, please come down. Okay, 6 of you, so you have 3 pairs. So I want you to consider some focusing questions like, what career pathway are you focusing your job search on? Say, oh, talk to yourself, look at the questions on the screen. There are focusing questions. What career pathways are you focusing your job search on? What is your dream organization? Is it a large one or a big one? What kind of position are you most qualified for? Remember, assessment of self. And how does that kind of position align with your personal values? So decide who starts first. You talk for 2 minutes. Okay, so switch roles. Now switch. The person starting now. You be the listener. Have a minute. Okay, your time is up. So let's hear you, Paul. Paul is a PhD student. Can you share with us what it was like when you were the one pushing for this network? What was it like? Talk to us for 30 seconds.
Okay, thank you very much. My name is Paul, and I had a talking session, and introduce myself. I'm actually working on IT innovation. And then this is Duncan, a friend now, the Center for Applied Education. Yes. And so we have shared experiences, and eventually about to not only collab, because I told him the essence of my research, which is remediating the environment.
Okay, tell us more about him, so he can tell us more about you.
Okay, thank you. I understand it all. All right, he is in the industry, and I'm in the academy. So he's a student also, and pursuing career. He wants to get a career in the oil and gas sector. So
what value did he project? What value then to him did he project?
Okay. The values among the ones you listed, he has focus and the long term achievement. He pushed towards achieving settling down in his area, which is oil and gas, and I think that's all I got.
Okay, I know it was a short time, so let's see. Given, what was it like? How did he start the networking conversation with you?
Okay, my name is Dunkara. He started by telling his name, and we looked at some of the issues, which is his career path, and he's looking at, he's doing his PhD, and he wants to concentrate more on environmental remediation, and owing to the fact that I'm also in oil and gas industry, we can actually network effectively to
be able to
achieve the cost.
It's okay. Let's hear from her.
Good morning. I'm Asubo Elizabeth. Met Charles. He's a PhD student of biochemistry, and his career goal is to be a researcher or a lecturer. And one of his personal values is he's a goal getter. Thank you.
Okay. Let's hear from you, Charles.
Okay, I'm Chukwu Charles, Department of Biochemistry, PhD student. I met Asumbo Elizabeth from the Department of Plant Science and Biotechnology. So she's someone very desirous of making a career in lecturing, research, and then being a consultant in industries. So because of the time, I couldn't get the values.
Beautiful. Let's give to Engel.
Thank you.
Yeah, tell us what she did that got your attention when she was the person seeking the contact.
Yes, I'm meeting a wonderful friend, Vivian Lane, and a medical student. But she's like I told you, she wants to be a researcher. Especially, maybe to be a researcher, but also to be the manager of such an institute. And good time, just have the time for communication. Thank
you. Let's hear from her. What was interesting in the conversation for you?
Good morning, all. My name is Vivian. I met Tango, a friend, who was able to tell me that his intention is for him to be a lecturer and a senior lecturer, and then being a master student who can always communicate together, then he can use me as a means to, you know, have a practice of how he can actually teach people, you understand, and also relate with some communications around. Thank you.
Thank you. You make your way. Thank you so much, all of you. I think it was an interesting activity. Yeah, because this group all knew the names of their partners. So it's very important, I tactically skip that, when you're meeting someone, you should say your first name twice before you say your surname. Because people like to be called by their first name. So as you're giving them a firm handshake, I am Ukarian, Mwichi. Yeah, before you say who you are. It's very important that people know you by name. So all of them could say the names of their partners. That was fantastic. I told some persons they are not going to know my partner say it, but they all call them by first name. So that's a very great one. So you're following in this workshop. Very important. So and to say what you are doing, what should interest the other person. And then you had him out. You didn't steal the show to speak all through. Activity 3, we had career objective beginning. So after what we've learned now, I want you to consider that research career objective. Broaden it, make it narrow.